You're tuned in to The Dish TV, the talk show from SRI International that highlights our people, products, and technology portfolio. This series will focus on startups incubated by SRI Ventures. We invest in big ideas that create world-changing enterprises to make people safer, healthier, and more productive. I'm Reenita Malhotra Hora, Head of Marketing and Communications. In this episode, my guest is Navya Davuluri, CEO and co-founder of Curie, a respiratory health platform. I asked Navya how SRI's conversational AI technology is being used to monitor patient symptoms and what impact Curie is making during the coronavirus pandemic.
Curie is basically a healthcare startup that is focused on really transforming the standard of care for respiratory conditions, right? So these are conditions like asthma, COPD, COVID being one of them. The idea behind Curie is similar to imagining having a voice assistant type of a technology in your home, wherever, or in a place wherever these patients are, and without really asking the patient to describe what is going on with their condition, what can you learn by listening to their breathing patterns?
It sounds like then it's much more than conversational technology,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, yes. There's a variety of symptoms that a physician is looking for when they're trying to understand the state of your chronic condition. So let's imagine that you're a patient with, a condition like COPD or COVID. You know, the first things that they're going to ask or listen for, or things like, how often have you been coughing? Have you experienced any shortness of breath? Let me listen to your lungs and understand if you have any symptoms like wheezing, etc. So these are all audible symptoms that a physician is going to try and understand before, you know, they try and decide how severe your state is, right? So Curie is exactly doing the same thing, except from a distance. So without being, you know, what if we can provide the same information to the clinician without the patient actually having to be with a physician or under direct supervision of a physician all the time. That's exactly what we do.
Has conversational AI ever been used in this way for healthcare diagnostics?
Not so far. So that's what is unique about what we're doing at Curie and how we have utilized some of the technology that was being developed at SRI. So as you've said, there are a lot of ways in which conversational AI speech specifically has been tried to use, right, in order to understand a patient's condition, be it in mental health, etc. But the idea of not necessarily paying attention to speech, but to audio alone, in fact, entirely discarding speech, if at all it exists in the audio stream that we are getting, is the technology behind Curie.
Does the platform actually collect and present the data only, or does it actually do some data analysis as well?
It does a lot of analysis, in fact. So what happens is every room where there is a patient that is either admitted or quarantined to, we have installed a smart tablet essentially with our technology on it. And the device not only identifies symptoms and deteriorating symptoms in these patients, but does a lot of analysis to help the physicians understand on a daily basis, who are the people that are at risk of significant deterioration? So the first thing that all the physicians get on a daily basis is a report that tells them these are the people in the, you know, really severe red category, meaning they require your immediate attention. And hence by highlighting that to them, they're able to attend to those patients much quickly and if required, make any changes to the treatment plan.
Tell us a little bit more about who you worked with at SRI and what it took to really incorporate this into the Curie platform.
We worked very closely with the team at Star Labs. You know, they are the people that developed the idea of being able to detect certain types of audio events from a continuous stream of audio. They were specifically when I started as an EIR at SRI, they were specifically trying to understand if it would be possible to pick up while a conversation is happening with an elderly person, things like whether they're coughing, you know, if they happen to be coughing during a conversation with a voice, you know, assistant or a conversational bot type of a technology, would it know whether the elderly patient is experiencing any coughs type of events? That's where the original technology came from. Dr. Dimitra was essentially the lab, you know, the leader that was developing this type of technology. And we worked with that team, Diego and Dimitra and the rest of the folks at Star Lab to specifically adopt this type of technology to respiratory conditions, right? So we expanded the number of things we can detect from audio, quite a bit from when we've originally adopted, you know, from which we've originally licensed the technology.
Of course, you've mentioned a range of respiratory diseases, right? From asthma to COVID-19. Mm-hmm. So tell me, this global pandemic that we're currently facing, how has this presented an opportunity for Curie?
Actually, it's interesting. The way we have, of course, you know, our work has been dedicated towards understanding respiratory conditions. And COVID happens to be similar in the sense the type of symptoms someone experiences at an early stage contracting the virus are similar to what they would experience with other respiratory conditions. So that's what was helpful in basically making sure that our product is aligned with helping patients that are COVID positive. And then the breakthrough was essentially in understanding whether or not we could help clinicians guide through treatment plan. So what our original, before our current deployments in COVID, we'd been doing some work with a few physicians that were part of NHS in UK, where Curie got deployed on a few patients that were COVID positive. And, there essentially we were able to show that Curie was picking up these events that indicated disease progression much sooner than the physicians were able to find out using current standard of care. So that, you know, essentially helped us realize that it could be a quite an a valuable tool in helping physicians better manage the treatment population. So the idea here is, if you were to know ahead of time who is deteriorating quickly, even before, you know, the current standard of care, whatever tools that they had access to were saying that, then how would you change the treatment course and for that specific patient? And would that result in, better treatment outcomes, right? So positive treatment outcomes.
So what did you actually see? Did you see these changes happening?
Oh, absolutely. So there's a number of cases where the data and the analysis that we've shared with the clinicians was extremely powerful in enabling new treatment options. So for example, there's this one patient who, according to standard vitals and the current standard of care, was doing fine, but Curie identified that this patient is deteriorating really rapidly. The physicians were able to confirm that that in fact was the case using advanced imaging technologies and whatnot. And hence, they were able to change the treatment and were able to put her on an experimental plasma transplant treatment that some physicians are trying out right now. And that, in fact, helped her recover really quickly. And she actually got discharged 3 to 4 days after she was put on the new treatment plan. So, in her situation, Curie played a really significant role in changing the course, of how she was going to actually perform.
Where do you envision Curie will be a year from now, perhaps while we're still in this pandemic situation, and then after that, perhaps 4 or 5 years?
The pandemic has presented very unique opportunities to highlight what is unique about Curie. So, the idea is that, in a year from now, we would like Curie to be adopted on a much wider, scale and to specifically help with the pandemic. But moving on, 4 to 5 years from now, the idea is that physicians would really understand the value of learning about patients' health in a proactive manner, as opposed to reacting to whatever conditions or symptoms they seem to be experiencing, and that becomes the standard of care, and that's where Curie would be playing a central role in informing who should be getting treated, as opposed to the patient determining that they needs to be seen. So that's where we would like Curie to be playing a central role.